why are you here?
right here at the border. Why do you think it's important to be here?
You know, not too many people actually come to the border and see an example of a wall that's talked about so often in our country. Mm. And people don't have a sense of what it means to actually have a wall in a random place that separates people in such a dramatic and final way. And so I think it's really important for a lot of people to come and experience what this is like, because it's really disquieting to see someone on the other side that you know you can't reach, and yet they're humans just like we are.
Both of you have talked about walls. Do walls work?
Well, I think they work. They work in one way. They certainly keep people from connecting to each other. So if that's the goal, then they work. They certainly don't block the flow of ideas. They don't block social media. Yeah. They don't block human aspiration. They don't block love. So they don't work for those things.
You say that you dream about walls and conflict.
I dream about walls in general. Anywhere, like any walls, the wall of your house. If I see it and I love it, I'm going to dream about it and would want to paste it the next day. But we tried, and look at this. We're here today. And we even, like, were able to exchange and, you know, like, the whole project, people might come and see the way it went on social media and people start sharing. Those images, you know, travels. And the mother of Kikito, that's what she told me. I say, I hope that people will stop seeing us like, you know, animals, like rapists, like all these things.
That's something to be afraid of.
Exactly.
Can I ask you both about... Mm. The argument being made by the Trump administration that walls are needed, that we need a big, beautiful wall, and that those who are here illegally, about 11 million, they should go back to Mexico and Central America. Is that the American way?
Of course not. Mm-hmm. However, he's saying it over and over again because he gets some applause for it. I think that, first of all, anyone who lives on the border is against the wall. So what's really interesting is that the majority of people who are advocating for the wall don't live anywhere near the border. Mm-hmm.
But in France and in the United States, people are saying, well, these are countries of laws. We have to follow the law. Then what's the other argument?
People are forgetting that the genesis of our country was to welcome people from all over the world who had the desire, the will, the hard work, the ethic, the faith that they could come here and build a life and have certain freedoms that they couldn't have anywhere else. And we shouldn't forget that, because that's the lifeblood of America. That's one of our core American values, is that we do welcome those from all over the world. And those who take the risk to come here and risk everything and leave behind everything, those are actually the people we want in our country, because they're the entrepreneurs, they're the innovators, they're the creatives, they're the risk takers. And to close ourselves off from that, I think, is absolutely ignoring not only our history, but our future.
You met with Trump, correct?
Mm-hmm.
Last March?
I did, yes.
Can you tell us a little bit what happened in that meeting?
We had a very cordial meeting. We talked about immigration, we talked about Dreamers, we talked about DACA. He, at that point, he was very supportive of not rescinding DACA, and he was very supportive of Dreamers.
And then when you heard that he was ending DACA, what was your reaction?
I was devastated. And I work personally, I've worked with hundreds of Dreamers and worked with them through high school and through university and through graduate school, and now many of them are in the workforce, and they're extraordinary individuals, and I think that it's a big, big mistake